Dear students, today we will discuss variables and data types in programming language. So, in one of the previous modules, we have discussed the concept of variable, which we should refresh, that high-level programming languages allow locations in the main memory to be referenced by descriptive names rather than by numeric addresses. And such a name is known as variable, which we used in one of the previous examples as price and shipping price, etc. So there are some primitive data types which are normally available in all of the languages. The data types that are included as primitives in a programming language. And normally those are integer, float, character, and Boolean data types. So here we will discuss this in the online compiler of C++, as some of you will be studying C++ language in the next courses. So we will not go into very details. I will just show you that how the variable is defined in C++ and how that variable can be assigned the value and can be outputted on the screen. So if you go onto this address which we have shown on this screen, so here I have opened this address. This is basically the compiler of C++. So whatever we write in the high level language is translated in the machine language, as we have discussed in the previous modules. So this is a statement cout ; sign. This statement is used to output whatever is written between the double quotes in this statement. So we have written cout hello world, so that hello world is being displayed on the screen. So for example, you can write here hello to ITP course, introduction to programming course. And if you run, so you will see that this is the output of this program. So in this program we can define the data types which we have discussed in this module. So for example, if you define an integer variable or data type, you can write int and you can give the name, for example price semicolon. So now one variable has been defined in the RAM, and the address of the RAM has been given a name of price. So remember, in one of our previous module, that address was 6C in the RAM, and that address have been given a name as price by using this C++ code. And for example, you want to define a float variable. Float variable is basically, first of all, I should also tell you that integer variables are only those variables that can contain the integer values. For example, the numeric values, the complete values, like any value which is complete, which does not contain any decimal point. So any value like 100, 20, 5, 20,000, 20 million. So such values are considered as integers. And of course, there is a range of integer value which we are not telling you in this course. And if you want to define a float variable, you can write float and the name of that variable, for example, shipping price. So this variable is a float variable, which means this variable can contain a data which could be of type having decimal points within it. So this means we can store information like 20.5 in this float variable. In other words, we can store any value that contains a decimal point in the memory location being referenced by the shipping price. However, we cannot store any value that contains a decimal point in the memory location that is being referenced by the variable price. So similarly, we can define another variable, character grade, for example. So this is another variable which will contain only one single character, and that is, for example, your grade. So whether you get A grade, B grade, C grade, or F grade, so those grades will be stored or can be stored in a memory location that has been referenced by the variable name grade. So we have discussed in this module about how the variables and their data types can be defined actually in the programming language. And then in some of the next modules, we will discuss that how you can put the required data into these variables, and then you can see what happens. So if we summarize today's module, we have learned the concept of variable, and we have defined the variables and different data types in an online compiler of C++ that was assisting us to write high-level language code, which is familiar to us, and converting that code into the machine code. And we have also print out our messages, hello to ITP course in a C++ language, and we have seen the output. And we have also defined integer, float, and character variables. And in the next modules, we will assign some value to those variables as well.